Total War Darth Mod Great Britain campaign, and this, my friends, over the last time, where we are systematically, my friends, moving through our lands here on a very highly localized, sort of, dare we say, an enlarged anti-partisan operation here to clear out our territories here in the sort of Mediterranean in Constantinople, and indeed in Greece itself. We are trying to get our economy back up to rude health here, and at the same time trying to eliminate these foes that have sort of raided our territory for a number of years. It has taken us a long time to muster the troops to be able to launch this operation. As you can see, we still have a great deal to do here. The Russians, the Polish, and indeed the Spanish have been absolutely causing us a great deal of havoc here in our lands here. But no more. We've had enough of this now. We are going to step up here, and we are going to eliminate, push them out, and hopefully set up a highly defensive line here across the sort of borders here of Constantinople, and also sort of the latter part of Greece as well. But as you can still, as I said before, we've still got a bit to do here, but we've got one thing in our favour. First of all, we are very, very close to our production centres and our sort of supply dumps, as it were. We have our roads fully upgraded, for the infrastructure is absolutely at full capacity here, so we're able to move our troops very quickly from one area to the next way to meet any sort of new threats. And secondly, our enemies are fighting independently of one another. There is no grand coalition, there is no sort of coalition of the willing here trying to take on Britain. If sort of, for example, Russia and Poland were cooperating with each other, that would be a whole different ball game for us. It really, really would. We would be up against some formidable forces here. But because we are able to sort of pick them off one by one, and there is no sort of cooperation, as you can see here. Now, if they were operating with each other, this is a Polish army here. We can probably just quickly have a look at that if possible. Yes, indeed, there it is. Look at that. That's a Polish army that's landed once again here on the coast of Greece, which is... This area here has been an absolute bane for us, because we've gotten Spanish, Poles, the Russians always landing here. We're going to probably put a force here to stop that from happening, or to at least meet them on the beaches should they decide to do so again. But as you can see here, we've got... If Poland and indeed Russia were to cooperate, these two forces here would be helping each other. But as you can see, we're able to pick off this Russian sort of force here that's sort of really sort of been dug in here for a number of years. We're able here in Romalia to really pick off this Russian force. Now, it is not going to be a simple battle. As you can see, they've got rockets, they've got the mortars, again, the bane of our lives here. I think they bought some 24-pounders, indeed they have. So they've got two 24-pounders, they've got rocket troop, they've got 4-inch mortars, and they've also got a 6-pounder here. They've got two cavalry, and the rest, of course, line infantry, militia, and some light infantry. But look at this, my friend. This is like Christmas come early here. It really is. Look at the magnificence of this army here. It is absolutely exemplary. Look at this. The finest troops we have available to us, bar none. Now, I know that many of you have requested to be generals here. As soon as we have cleared this land here, we will be looking at promoting generals here to different armies here. So of course there will be the opportunity. There will be also opportunities in the future as well, if things go well. But as you can see in the distance here in the north, we have Poland committing a great deal of troops to this campaign here. We do have Constantinople or Istanbul, well garrisoned, well defended by a fully stacked army here. And also Greece is at the moment, I think we can probably move back here and have a quick look here as well. Indeed. Now we've had to move back this army here to defend against the remnants of the Spanish army. Remember, we fought the Spanish army here previously, but they retreated all the way back to here. Now, if we left this and open, they would probably come along and take Greece, and we would be left by... We've had to send back a force here. We've had to disengage this force here from the army group currently trying to carrying out this operation here to clear our lands. And indeed, if this Polish force decides to move down as well, it's important that we have the forces in place. Now, we do have also here Patras, which is under our control. We have a mighty fleet here as well, guarding the sort of Patras port here as well. But again, it's an operation that we're carrying out very, very local here. This is not going to be some huge sort of sweeping sort of amount of army groups sweeping everything before them. Highly localized operation here, an anti-partisan operation. We want to clear as many of the enemies we can out of our lands. We've already done so quite effectively here. And also, you can see here, we've still got this Polish and indeed a Russian force here, but on the outskirts here up in the north here, we've still got the Poles. We've got another very decent here by looking here, very compact Russian army here up in the in this sort of town up here as well, up in the north. But again, we've got the forces to meet this. Now, as you can see, this is exemplary. This really is a wonderful sight here. Four 24-pound... Oh, gentlemen, please, I beg your pardon, good sir. We've got a 24-pounder horse guard. We've got a 24-pounder howitzer, but then look at that. We've got two 32-pounders and an additional 24-pounder, but look at this. Royal Cuirassier Guards. We've got Marines. We've got some Lancers. Look at this, my friends. Marines, late infantry here. More Marines, and indeed, look at this. Absolutely packed to the rafters. We've even got line infantry guards here. A wonderful-looking army. It really is. Look at that, exemplary. We've also got a wonderful sort of reinforcing army here. But I think it might be best if we keep this army here as the army coming in first. Because of this, we want to keep this up. Look at this. I mean, look at it. It's magnificent, sir. Look at this. Royal Irish, Life Guards, Guard units, and indeed the second reinforcing army. Equally as good here. Absolutely packed to the rafters here with plenty of heavy artillery. Really what we need here. Because we're able to fall back upon our production centres, because we're able to have our supply dump so close to the front lines, we're able to reinforce quite quickly here, but we need to keep these forces here in good order. And to that end, we're going to use this army as our main reinforcing army if we need it, because you can see it already taken a little bit of damage here in the fighting previously against Spain and against Poland. We want to keep these armies here as fresh as we possibly can. We still need to remove this Polish force. We still need to also move in and remove this Polish force and this Russian force, and indeed this Russian force here. We then need to establish a firm defensive line as possible along the border of Greece here and Serbia and also Bosnia here. And indeed, we've got this really open, porous border here between Bulgaria and Constantinople, Istanbul, Romania. So once again, we need to sort of start bringing troops in here as well as quickly as we possibly can. But our main goal here is to try and clear these lands and really throw back our enemies. We probably will leave an army here on the beach here as well to stop this landing happening all the time. We've also got a massive Russian force behind us in the south on one of our islands. That is of great concern to us, because we might have to pull troops off the fighting here in the front lines, which to deal with those Russian forces if they decide to sort of make that move against us here, against Greece. If Greece falls, we will be in a lot of trouble, because it will not mean production centres. And we really have fought hard. We spent a huge amount of our money to try and get these forces into position here. We mustn't waste the opportunity we've got here. Now, we've got an opportunity to really give our enemies a damn good thrashing. And by damn, my friends, that is exactly what we're going to do here. Right, let's begin here. The fight here, I believe the fourth or fifth fight in Romania, has been brutal. A brutal campaign. This operation has gone according to plan, but it is definitely going to cost us a number of troops here. Let's take this fight, my friends. Look at that, we've got a lot to do. We're sending a message here to our enemies, to Spain, to Russia, and indeed to Poland. If you enter our territory, if you come to try and claim and harass and sort of, you know, ravage our lands, you will pay a dear price for it. And indeed, we have got a Scandinavian operation possibly underway as well, potentially taking Norway and giving it back to the Swedes, and then taking Sweden, keeping it for ourselves, because it is an excellent production base. It also gives the opportunity to strike against the Russians further deeper into Scandinavia, but also to cross the Baltic into Russian lands there, maybe St. Petersburg, who knows. But we've got to really take that fight. We're just chipping away at the edges of the sort of the Russian Empire, chipping away at the edges of our enemies here, because at one point we were absolutely doomed. Britain was on the edge of a precipice. We were staring into the abyss. It really was that bad. But we've managed to pull ourselves... Oh my goodness, be pleased, gentlemen. What a magnificent sight here. Look at this. This is absolutely... It warms the cockles of your hearts. It really does. Now, let's have a look at the... Oh my goodness me. Look at this hill. What a perfect position here for artillery. And also, it's got a good defensive base here. This base here makes it difficult for enemy to sort of swoop around here. It would break up their formations. Mind you, it does slope down quite brutally down here on this right flank. But the left, equally so. We've got a good wall system here is all we could use. So if you put the artillery here, we could have infantry running across the wall here as well. And outwards, oh my God, Bennett. Look at this cavalry. Oh, ho, ho. Look at those Royal Cuirassiers. Look at that. What a joy to see. I mean, this is brutal. Oh, this is going to be brutal. We shall absolutely show the Russians what we're made of here. Look at those lancers. Look at those lancers. Now, the council, once again, has come up with some wonderful advice. It really has, in what we should do here, clearing the lands. But also, latterly, once we've done that, striking against Sweden, most of the advice has been to, you know, give Sweden back the lands if we take it off back from. We've got a very powerful army in Britain waiting to strike out. But look at what we've got here. Look at this here. It is magnificent. Now, what we should really be doing is putting the artillery in the proper position here. Now, we've got this artillery here, which does really need that elevation if it's going to do any damage here. Look at that. Oh, that's a magnificent sight. It's got a good, it's got good outlook here, right across the lands here. Where is the village we were fighting for? It must be over in the distance. I'm assuming it's over in the distance there in the, over there, probably through this road network. As you can see, the road runs parallel to the battlefield here, across into the distance. Now, that's where the village would be. So the village we're fighting for is over here, in this sort of ravine, as it were, between these two sort of mountain ranges. Now, I think I'm going to have a 32-pounder either side of here, because again, we have the howitzers, and they... Oh, goodness me. It's an absolute joy to see, it really is. We have the two lots of 32-pounders here. Gentlemen. Thank you. We will bring all of these, of course, into one. Now, I don't really like putting these on the hill here, but it'll still give us good fire coverage here on this particular flank here. Now, that is a significant amount of firepower bearing down upon whoever comes against us here. I'm going to put the general here, of course, behind. I know we're losing the hill here, and it's quite right. It's sort of on the right flank, quite dominant by the right flank here, but we have to adjust to what our the region gives us here, the battlefield gives us here, the terrain, dare I say, gives us. I think what we'll do is where's that late Marines here? I think we have the Marines here. We'll have the 18th, I think, here in the vanguard. Oh, look at that. It's even got a stepping stone defense here. Look at that. So we're going to definitely put them. Remember, we are attacking the Russians, so the chances are we're going to have to send out men to attack them. But for our own defense, we want definitely... Oh, my goodness me. Look at that. Look at these. Oh, my God. Please, gentlemen, please. What a magnificent sight. Look at that art. Look at that. Look at their uniform. Look at those hats. They're magnificent. And to that end, we might even use these gentlemen to strike out against the Russians. I think we will do then. We'll change our dynamic here. We'll put the 80th Regiment of Foot in the vanguard of the defence here, with the 81st on the right. Again, the territory doesn't give us any deployment issues just yet. I think we'll put the 24th Foot Guards on the left here. Wait, let's have a look at these. Oh, that is exceptional, sir. Gentlemen, why are you out of... Thank you. Now, we are going to need troops that are going to be possibly moving into fight here. We've got Marines here, but I think we will use the late Marines as our battering ram here. We've got one, two, we've got four regiments. I think we'll use our standard three regiment attacking force with the cavalry. I think we'll also send two cavalry regiments on the right. Oh, look at this. What a wonderful display of power here. And gentlemen, thank you. But we'd better close off this right flank just in case. And I think we'll use Marines, early Marines, as a chat. Yeah, as I suspected, this here is going to prevent us doing that. As you can see here, that's going to give us a few problems right there. So to that end, we'll do that, and we'll move them up to here. Just a will that actually fit in there? Indeed, it will. Wonderful. Of course, we can adjust, and we will adjust, depending on what happens here. And of course, we've got the other Marines here. Then we do have these late Marines here. Four regiments. Now they will come under some severe fire once we get moving here. We do have our cavalry here. Ready to move with the demarcation line here. Gives us still got a decent amount of depth to be able to run here. I think what we'll do is we'll just move here. We need to crush in this Russian resistance as quickly as possible. But also to defend as firmly as possible. We can always adjust our lines. Let's start this battle, my friends. Let's clear out these Russian forces. Oh my goodness me. If you would please, gentlemen. Double time! Gentlemen. I mean, it's an absolute bloodbath, sir. Now we're going to try and flank these gentlemen as quickly as we possibly can here. Now, are they going to move against us? It looks like they are. And if that's the case, we need to move quickly here with our Marines. Look at this, look at this. The absolute apogee here of British fighting power. Please, that was my mistake. Do beg your pardon, gentlemen. A magnificent sight, sir. Open fire! Open fire, gentlemen. Open fire! Here they come, here they come. Oh my gosh, look at this, this is an absolute bloodbath, sir. Oh, I've been absolutely decimated here. Prepare to farm! We've got to move our flank here. This land is going to replace us here. This has been an absolute massacre, sir. Ceasefire, gentlemen. Look at this, what a magnificent sight that was. Absolutely blitzed. Blitzed. There is nothing left of them. Oh, the heavy cuirassier guards, sir. How about them? You want this general dead, gentlemen, dead, please. But damn, we'll teach the Russians a lesson they like, so which they'll never forget, I can assure you. Look at that. It's an absolute bloodbath. You want that general dead, please, gentlemen? I want his head, please. Oh, what a wonderful sight. Absolutely obliterated them with minimal losses. That was a wonderful fight. We've cleared out that Russian force. We can then move our forces. Look at that. We lost 151 men. 151 men lost. They've got 8 men remaining. Gone. Absolutely blitzed. At that, now, my goodness me, that was a wonderful sight there. We're going to keep this. We're going to keep this. Look at that militia mostly. So we're going to keep this Spanish force in check there. We've got 4,226. That is hitting us pretty hard there. Our trade is being hit here by the Mughal Empire and indeed the Ottomans. Sweden has been completely cut off. So we're getting hit here pretty bad by the Ottomans. The Ottoman Empire is being cut off by whom? Ah, Russia. Is, of course... Where's the Ottoman... Ah, that's just that. There's all we've got. There's the Ottomans, is that. But also the Mughal Empire, which for some reason, look at that, 3, because it's being raided somewhere. Yeah, being raided, that's why we're losing so much money here, down to 3 there. And whom is raiding it, pray tell? Probably, bingo, there it is. Courland. We're at peace with France, which is good. We're starting to build up this force here, but we need to try and keep. Now, of course, Britain has been fully. Oh my goodness me! Look at this. We've got almost got a full. This the. Oh, good grief! Look at that fusiliers. Oh, a magnificent sight. Now we are going to be hitting Norway here. Excuse me. And we're going to attempt to give that back to Sweden. Hopefully they can then begin to sort of start to repair some of their assets here. What have they got here? That's been hit there. That out, good grief. Oh my goodness me, that is a lot of cannon. That is a stupendous amount of cannon. And of course we've got Sweden, which we're going to be aiming for ourselves here. But of course we do need to really hit a bit. But look at the size of the Russian Empire, it's just absolutely staggering. And as I was saying here, my friend, look at this. 1, 2, 3, got an army group here and all these really powerful naval forces here that could absolutely blitz our fleet quite comprehensively here. And we've got Spain with another army on the way here. Look at these Walloon guards. They're just sending everything they can at us here. Now we could engage this fleet here and sink it, but we would lose a significant amount of our fleet. We must keep our these intact here. We've got to really take the fight to these. Well, that's being replenished here, this army that took a real, not a real beating, but it did at least get engaged in the fighting there. Now, that's going to take 6,000 to bring that back up to full there. This is probably a similar amount. It does indeed. So we've got to find 6,000 to bring these up. But before we do that, we only lost 152 men here, so I think we can probably engage this Polish force here. That's got a tremendous amount of artillery and a lot of cavalry. What have we got here? Just that Russian force there and the Russians here. It's a pretty powerful Russian force there. Now, We've got a lot of cavalry here, plenty of guns of our own. What about here? No, the cavalry here is limited to only two. So I think it might be best if we probably use this force here. I think what we will do is remove... I think we'll use this force here to remove this Polish force. Mind you, that is a really, really very powerful Polish force there. And we'll probably use these to remove the remainder of this force here and also here as well. Mind you, it's going to cost us an absolute arm and a leg here to really... Right, we're going to replenish these. We're going to send these forces in. And they're going to be fighting up against pretty elite forces here. Sir, your orders? Sir. I think we might send in this force here to deal with the Poles. Yes. That's of equal strength to the Poles. And we can send them into the sea. We're going to use them, we're using what I sort of deem a backhanded chop here. We're using the Adriatic here is sort of our anvil, where we push the forces against the sea here and crush them against the sea, so they got nowhere to escape indeed here. Now the Spanish will definitely land here. Now if we can put a force into place here, right, first things first is to move up and engage this Polish force here that's been sat here for a while. I think we're going to use these gentlemen here that have been with us for a very, very long time. General Mendoza here has been fighting on many a front here. We're going to use General Mendoza to remove this Spanish gentleman, please. This Polish force here. That is a powerful Polish force. Be under no illusions. They've got some very, very fine troops here. But we're going to take this fight. Now, we don't want any of these forces to be engaged with us at all. In fact, we'll probably leave this army where it is here. The rest have to remain out of this fight if possible, because we're trying bit by bit. And then what we're going to do is we're going to leave one of these, this force here, where the Poles were, because the Spanish will attempt to land here. It is the only strip of land that they can land apart from, they land around by here maybe. But if we can cut off this landing point, it'll stop the Spanish being able to land there. As you can see, they've got a full force waiting to land it, with about three regiments of Walloon Guards, which are brutal to fight against. They really are. So we're going to take this fight again. The second battle here, really trying to clear this land as quickly as we possibly can here to get ourselves into a better position here. Right, another fight begins, my friends. Another fight here, this time in Greece. This time in Greece. This has been proven to be quite the campaign here. Remember, this is high localized, very, very localized for us indeed. We can't start expanding sort of exponentially, as it were. We can't start expanding massively against Russia now. This has to be bit by bit. First of all, we have to clear our lands. As you can see, it's going to cost 6,000 gold just to bring those buildings back up to full, back to full capacity. We can only do that once per sort of month, as it, or once per seat, once every 3 months. We can only afford to do that. That's how sort of brutal this campaign is. Our finances are squeezed, so we've got to really look after, we've got to sort of nurture our finances, as it were, and try and maybe build up a little bit of a bank here. Because if that, as you can see, that army group that's in Crete, I believe, moves against us, we are going to be in a lot of trouble there. Right, we've been given a decent amount, a decent starting position here. The terrain is not too bad. Again, we've got this sort of mini sort of valley here that slopes down off this mound here, this hill here. Can we put troops down this flank here? No, we can't. Only here. So this is going to again prevent us from giving full access to it. But again, we've got to use any advantage we get. I know the howitzers can fire over things anyway, but I do like to give them an elevated position so they got that good line of sight, gentlemen. So immediately we're going to set them up right here. Let's bring them into fire control. To see again, General Mendoza once again being called upon to fight for the British Empire, has done so with great bravery, sir, and with great courage, and indeed discipline, which of course he's well known for. Now, I think we put the 37th again there, one of our most veteran units here. 37th, right in the vanguard of the defence here. We might be attacked here by the Poles. They do have a very, very capable fighting force with them. Got the 37th already in the vanguard there. Of course, we've got the Coldstream Guards as well. Nothing to be sniffed at all there. I think what we'll do is we'll use our regiment of foot. We're right on the cusp of that sort of particular slope giving us problems, but we're managing thus far. And again, on the left flank here, we'll put the 53rd Regiment. Oh, look at that. Now, that's a strong defensive base here, but we do need to... We've got to use forces. Again, we have to take the fight to the Poles. We've got two regiments of cavalry here, of horse guards. We've got to use these very, very sparingly here if possible. We need to target their artillery, because most of these enemies do have incredible artillery strength. And again, we want to move out, so we're going to use the Royal Irish Regiment here to do some of the hard work for us here out in the field. Again, we're going to put together a strike force, Royal Irish, and I think we'll also put the Coldstream Guards in with the Royal Irish. Now, that is a powerful strike force there. As you can see, two regiments here of Coldstream Guards, and then of course the Royal Irish Regiment. Look at that. That's a pretty powerful strike force, assisted by two regiments of heavy cavalry. Now, we're going to set ourselves up. We've got a 36th Regiment here, and also the 54th. I think we put the 54th on the right. And we'll put the 36th. Let's just get things in order here. Gentlemen, please. The 36th on the left. I'm not going to take any chances here at all. What? Straighten that line, please, gentlemen. Yep. We've got some guard units. Now, we don't need to use all these forces, because I think we'll try and keep some of these. Remember, we've got to try and really sort of look after the forces we've got here. We can't, you know, as you can see, our economy is not going to be sort of able to absolutely recruit vast amounts of men here. We've got to be able to sort of look after, nurture, as it were, the forces we've got at our disposal. So I think what we'll do is we'll put the Royal Highlanders to guard this extreme right flank, just angling it slightly here. And we've got this, I think what we'll do, we've put this Royal Highlanders in reserve here to be used if necessary. We want to try and keep these gentlemen out of harm's way if possible. Because these guards units are incredibly effective fighting force, but if we don't need to use them, then we won't. But again, this is going to be a bit of a gamble here. We're going to hit them on the left flank here, there, our left, their right. But if necessary, we'll pull the Royal Highlanders into here to protect this left flank. Let's begin the fight. Oh, they're right over there. They are left heavy here, or right heavy, should I say. It's going to give us perfect opportunity to move into position here. Let's get our forces into position. Disposal, a huge amount of cannon here. They're quite clearly ready to meet us here in the field. But we've got to try and roll up this force, because it is a very powerful force. Look at that, look at those fusiliers. We've got to hold our nerve here. Our Irish moving out. Here we go, this is what we're looking for here. Oh, look at that, they got lances. Guards moving into position. We've got to beat them to the punch here. How much cavalry they got? They've got a lot of cavalry here. They've got those fusiliers protecting that flank. Oh, you're tired, gentlemen. Steady now, steady. Forces here, that's it. Break, you fiends, break. Does that trigger them? That has triggered them to move now. Got to hold them. We've got to pick this up. We've got to pick this flank away here. Excuse any noise in the background, my friends. Excuse any noise in the background here. We've got the high ground here. I'm gonna try and flank them here completely. Gentlemen, obey your orders here. We've got a chance to absolutely roll up this flank here. Move! lads, keep those volleys going. If we can roll up this flank here, what we'll do is I think we'll bring in 3 war regiments here. It's a big commitment, but we've got to do it. If we can just break this flank here, it'd be a wonderful... Gentlemen, I've given you an order, please. The General Mendoza really does have a good grip here on discipline. Look at that, what a wonderful sight. They've absolutely been smashed in here. Let's bring in some fire support here. Got to avoid these spikes here, these horse traps here. So you decimated them here. Oh, this crossfire is doing a wondrous sight. Gentlemen, move. These fusiliers, yes. We're gonna break this flank here. In this flank here without them even realizing what's going on here, because if we can pick them apart we shall do that, believe me. Let's break them now. We've got the spikes there, we've got to be careful. Get out, lads, just hit and run. Just, yeah, that's it, they've shattered. Right, let's roll it. We've got the hill here. We've got to use this hill to our advantage here. Oh my goodness me! That was an absolute bloodbath there! They absolutely butchered that line regiment there. I mean, that was... look at that! What a shot that was! We could have took... we've just got to hold your hands up there and say you've taken a beat. Look at this, we're absolutely pouring fire onto them here. We've got to thread the needle here, we've got to thread the needle here. Take care of this. No, stay focused, gentlemen. Look at that, what a wonderful display of courage here. Ceasefire. Oh my goodness me, what a wonderful sight. We've used this hill here to absolutely butcher everything in our path here. If you come for it, sir, you will pay the ultimate price. We've broken. They've just had enough. They've shattered indeed. Out of 10 men, still, we've done a magnificent job here. Those fusiliers are standing up pretty well here to this barrage. Let's focus. Excuse any noise in the background there, my friends. You can guess who that might be there. What the blazes is going on here? Square, gentlemen. Magnificent sight, it really is a magnificent sight. Let's just pull them out, because we've got to be careful of these traps. We've set up so many different horse traps here. Thread that needle there, gentlemen. Thread that needle. They've broken. What's a joy to see. Look at that. Absolutely blitz the pieces here. Keep firing. That is a joy to see. Are they broken as well? They've had enough. Look at that, they've shattered, yes! What a victory that was, my friends. We've absolutely crushed in that Polish force. What a wonderful feeling that is there. Absolutely wonderful there. We lost 643 men, they've got 40 men left. Excuse any noise there in the background, my friends, as you can... We can probably actually remove all of these forces here. We're actually going to leave this army here to meet any potential invaders. That's a one. Mind you, we've lost one of our regiments here. Needs replenishing here. And again, 2,488. This regiment, this army here is already looking in position.
Your orders, Your Majesty, the Lord.
Can't move there. This one is Larissa here. That is looking more accomplished. But again, they can act together here. Now, what are we looking at here? That has got a stupendous amount. We've got the cavalry. This is the army to deal with this here. Plus one to morale. Excellent. And again, a fantastic display here. A fantastic display.
Yes, sir.
And we could chase them down here, but there's no point. That's got 40 men left in it. This army will soon be removed by this British force here. Look at that. Now we should just absolutely blitz them here. Patras, no recruitments here. We've got to keep our money here for keeping these forces in rude health. I think what we will do is we'll move down and engage this force here. What have we got here? In this here. That can wait. This army will. This will be our sort of advanced forward position as we sort of. Repair our forces on the move here, but this force here can deal with this Polish force.
Your order, Your Majesty.
Can't quite make it yet at the moment, but still, can this force here though, no, we want this to be replenished. We need these forces to stay in very good health here indeed. Now what have we got? How is the recruitment here? Now we can actually add additional forces here. We're going to make sure we've got a very, very strong force. £24 as well, I think. We're going to really make sure that we keep ourselves in good health. 5,280 here. What a fight. What a fight this is. It's magnificent. It really is. What's the force we've got here? Oh, that's a very, very good defensive force there. What's this Polish fleet looking like here? A mixed bag. And of course we've got the Poles now starting to really dig in here. Oh, good grief, that is a lot of artillery. And they seem to favour the artillery quite a bit here, the Poles. What have they got here? Yeah, Eastern European infantry mercenaries. Now of course they are at war with France, but again, hopefully France can keep Poland in check for a good while. We've also got Denmark here. Can we help Denmark in any other... Or Sweden, I beg your pardon. Denmark, Sweden, I beg your pardon. Nope, they've actually got more than we have. We've got, you know, a pretty good agreement with them here. But we are going to be moving towards Norway. I wonder if we can probably do that right now. Do we have the ships available to do that? Indeed, we've already prepared them. And what do we have recruiting here? Actually, we want to make sure that these gentlemen are in position before we do anything else. But we really are... This operation is going very well at the moment. It is going very well at the moment. Of course, we're going to be hit by this Spanish force here. That's a powerful Spanish force. These Walloon guards themselves are something to be concerned about. But the rest, Spanish bandits, not so much. We've got some colonial militia. We've got some Cabalistas. That's a very good Dragoon regiment there. And again, we've got Carbineers. But again, that's a bit to be expected for the Spanish to come for us again. But we've got an army, we've got several armies. We'll actually probably move this army down into the border regions here. Or in fact, we'll probably move this army out. Yeah. And this army will actually take over this town here. I wonder if we can engage here. Actually, we really want to get this replenished, this army up. And move on the go here. If we can take out this, because remember, if we move out here, and then the Poles here engage us here, and this army isn't at full strength, then we could have a problem. Attack. 2, 4, 8, 8. Let's do that. Let's replenish this army on the gain on the move. That means everything then is in position for us to sort of repair in the field and then move immediately on to tackle here. We're going to try and keep this, the beach here, this sort of in the Mediterranean Sea here available. I imagine the Spanish might even land here and maybe try and take Istanbul. But we need to clear the Piraeus force of Spanish here, and indeed just remove the last remnants of this Polish force here. Then this army can then be replenished and then move back into the field, or we might even move into Athens, because I've just got a sneaky feeling here that the Russians, seeing their forces soundly thrashed here on the sort of the mainland, might use Heraklion here as a base of operations they can move against us, because that is still a substantial amount of armies they've got here. If they hit us with these army groups, we would be pushed. That's why we've got to be vigilant here. So we might move this army, once it's dealt with the Spanish and the Poles here, into Athens, and then use the rest of the forces here, these other army groups here, to move and deal with the rest and move up our defensive line. I think we might even put together a strike force that might operate out of Macedonia to be able to sort of strike against the flank of any sort of Polish forces moving across through Bulgaria into Rumalia here. But again, my friends, I'm going to end this episode here. I hope you've enjoyed it. It has been a fantastic episode in terms of what we've managed to achieve here. Our goal is to remove the enemy from our lands we've got here in Greece and in Rumalia, and to bring our economy in this region back up to full strength. And then once we've done that, we can then start to really plan out our sort of where we're going to do here. We're going to then focus upon the Scandinavian, our Scandinavian expedition, which is going to be moving into Norway. We're going to give Norway to the Swedes, but when we take Sweden, we're going to keep that. Now, the councillor said, man, when you take Sweden, keep it for yourself, and then use Sweden as a sort of this bastion, this production centre, to be able to sort of put, you know, our get out economy, because the economy from here would be absolutely wonderful. It really would. Steam engine, it's all fully upgraded. We've got Malmo here, but we're very close to our allies of Sweden. What we will do then is we'll help Sweden take Finland, and we'll probably even look to take St. Petersburg. If we can chip away at the sort of the northern frontier of the Russian Empire, we can start to chip away, take a Scandinavia off them, and then ultimately start moving into the interior of Russia here. But as you can see, Russia just conquered everything it sees. I mean, it's up to the Indian border, and it's conquered all the Middle East apart from Syria. But that is a long way off. We've still got a lot to do in this operation. Our operation here in Greece is not finished. Still got a long way to go, but once it's finished, we want to be in the position where we can strike against any forces moving into our lands here, and then start to build up a good economy again, and start to really move our forces into possibly moving into Bosnia and Serbia, and even moving into Bulgaria, and start to clear out these lands here, moving the Poles back up towards the north, and hopefully giving France that elbow it needs here to start moving against the Poles again. Because if we can do that, if we can cooperate together, it would be absolutely fantastic. It's a pity we can't get an alliance with them, but of course they are allied probably with an enemy of ours, Spain indeed, which is a shame. That is a shame. And also we're at war with Louisiana, of course, so again, they're not going to be doing anything there with us. So we've got the same enemy, But that's about as much as we're going to cooperate together. We've got our own problems to deal with. We'll let France deal with its own problems, and we've got our own down here to sort out. But we're getting there. As soon as we can clear out these forces, the remnants of these forces, we can clear Ionina here and Epirus, clear these out, clear out Skopje, and then we can move our forces into position where we can even free up Thessaloniki here by moving a force into there and booting out this Russian naval force here. And we can even start to possibly put together our own naval force in the area. As you can see, we can hopefully then bring this back up to full strength as well. But that looks like Spain is going to start sending more troops along here, because of course they've got Tunis, and they're operating probably out of here as well, Sardinia. But that doesn't matter. Eventually, Spain will feel our vengeance as well. But, my friends, I'm going to end this episode here. If you've enjoyed it, if you have, please comment down below, my friends. Please keep your comments coming down below. They've been absolutely brilliant. And I'm going to take all your advice for this campaign as well. I need all your help from this advice for this campaign, my friends. So please, I need the council's advice as always. Please keep your comments coming down below. Wonderful as always. I hope you've enjoyed. Hope you've had a good weekend. Whatever you're doing, please be safe. Have a great time, my friends. And until next time, when I can promise you many, many more battles to come, a huge amount of battles to come, this is just the beginning of what is going to be a huge, huge campaign for us. But until then, my friends, bye for now.